So I'm drinking special Isotope RX juice in order to keep my body a bit clean in these difficult times. But that's absolutely not what I wanted to talk about today. Today I want to talk about the Black Box Analog Design HG2. And the reason is because a friend said to me that I needed to do it. So here you go, Krijn. All right, so apparently this is kind of a big thing. I've heard about it before, but never bothered with it. I found it a bit stupid looking with the blue tubes. I mean, I like red tubes more. Did I just say that? Orange glowing tubes, of course. But yeah, Meteor Mix Buzz's best friend, Black Box Analog Design HG2. By the way, I've been recommended to use dance music on this. Like, they say it's a big thing on dance music. I don't know. Let's see. There's a good reason why celebrated mix engineers like blah, 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 blah use the HG2 processor on their mixes. The boutique stereo processors, multiple diverse tube circuits, not only make tracks sound richer and fuller, they also make them sound louder. That's good. Bigger. That's good. Punchier. At the same peak level. Same peak level. Yeah, but it's your peak to RMS level will go down then. Like, there's not a lot of dynamic, if it's louder. Much more than a mere distortion box, the HG2 can import subtle harmonic coloration and sparkle without compromising fidelity or at brilliant saturation that totally changes the character of the sound. Now, what is this thing? Is this also a hardware box? No, this is only a plugin, right? So what we have here is a 3 rack unit size heavy black box filled with tubes and transformers. Is this also a hardware box? Oh, wow. Oh, okay, so it's an emulation. I thought it was just a plug-in with like an analog interface, which didn't make any sense, but now it makes more sense. Faithful emulation of the high-end black box, yeah, okay. Modeled transformer separate gain, yeah, yeah, yeah. It's a lot of text, not a lot of pictures. Oh, wait, before we take a look at it, $250. It better sound good for that price. All right, so this is it. On, off, screwed in. Not screwed in. Yeah, very dark. Saturation, pentode, full PPM. Oh, you have to really do this? Oh, what's that for your interface? Why do I... You just want to click on it. Come on, click, clickity click. Cal. Oh, okay. Different density, input, mix. Let's run some electronic music through it. Of course, from an artist the root. Here's the track Sandstorm. Again. Interesting, by the way, how it bypasses. Like, a normal tube equipment doesn't bypass by turning off the tube. The heater of the tube, because that's what's making the glow. Although, with blue tubes, I don't know if it's the heater. Anyway. Saturation. Now, come on. Kaboom, boom, boom. Up, up, up. Come on, come on. Give me some of that in. Ah! Ah! It's a button. I thought it was a light. That's pleasing. Yeah, 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 yeah. Oops. No output compensation. Okay. So, interesting thing what you can hear here. Sorry, I'm really overdoing it, I know. Oh, wait. Difference between triode and pentode, where I don't know how to describe it. I know how it technically works. The harmonics that a triode produces, you could say that harmonics of a triode are the opposite of the harmonics of a pentode. So one makes even harmonics and the other makes odd harmonics. I can't remember which one made which. What I do remember is that a triode in general sounds a bit warmer, while a pentode sounds a bit rougher. And this is also from my own opinion on how I perceive it. And that's interesting to listen to in such a track, like triode, and then triode back and then pentode. Oh, annoying that you... Pentode, triode, useless! I don't understand. Why do we still have plugins where we have to manually adjust the output gain? Like, why? We have a computer with like, I don't know how many gigaflops of processing power. It can do it for us. Now, an analog gear, it's not possible, but I also have two hands. So while I turn one up, I can turn the other one down. I cannot do that with just a mouse. So I don't understand why nobody is implementing this. Like, if you're making an analog simulation, at least make it better. And making it better is one of the things, is automatic output gain or like output gain compensation or whatever. This is just annoying. Anyway, calibration, dark. Yeah, they are in series, yeah. Air. Subtle, very subtle. Stay. Oh, it's so weird. I'm managing the levels more than I'm doing in my analog gear. It's so weird. I'm going to automate a lot in the edit. I already know that. Density. Resetting a parameter is also not possible. Annoying. Input. Yeah, okay, that's just gain. Reset everything. Okay. Kind of an interesting plugin. I do like the Pentode triode, you know, pretty straightforward. If you want to have Pentode distortion or triode distortion, it's in here. I have to agree with that it's a very nice color on electronic tracks. And honestly, I can make it with a tape machine or with like the same kind of color, maybe a bit different color, but at least in the same direction. But it's kind of an interesting thing. And if you think about it, like plugins like these, although they could have been made better, but that's really from a workflow point of view. I almost do not see a benefit of using this plugin compared to like something analog. Of course, you can take this with you in your laptop, like it's in the thing, in the laptop. Like it's just like this. And if you have to take like the whole analog box and all the analog boxes with you, then you're packing and unpacking like for 3 days. But if you are like in a fixed studio, then the hassle of like constantly like gaining and things, I'd rather do that analog, really. Because this is just annoying, like, okay, yeah, okay, cool. So we're playing, blah, 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 cool. Let's just for say there's a client sitting. Can you give me some like color or something here? Like, yeah, okay, let's turn this thing up. You're in the rest, like over the rest now. So you have to turn this one back. Like first it goes like this and then Now, other situation could be, let's reset it again. Client is sitting here. He's requesting some distortion. You're doing this. This takes way too much time. Like what? And again, like if I do this on an analog piece, then it's just like one hand on one, other hand on the other. Done. Give us automatic gaining. Like everybody that makes plugins should be thinking about this. Okay, that was a long monologue. Now the user interface, again, it takes up a lot of space. So that's something that I do not always understand. I start to understand now why some manufacturers choose skeuomorphic interfaces. So that's a new thing. It's mostly a marketing thing, because if you are used to using this thing like the analog box, and you're getting a plugin with an Air Windows interface, which is like simulating it, it doesn't feel right. So I start to understand why they're doing it, but I don't know. I think like the Air Windows interface, like no interface, which is an interesting approach. You have the skeuomorphic interface, but why not remake an analog piece of gear with a better interface? That it's so good that you don't even want to insert your analog box anymore. Like that I don't even want to insert my analog box anymore, because I know that a lot of engineers are already like selling their analog equipment. Those are usually the guys that I'm buying from. That would be a great challenge in the plugin world. So everybody that makes plugins, call yourself challenged. And if you think you know a plugin with a good user interface and a good sound, let me know that in the comments below or in an email. Now about the black box, I don't think it's snake oil. Brainworks in general is pretty serious about what they're making. I like the color that it's creating. I cannot compare it with the original. Price is a bit high. On the other hand, Plugin Alliance has like a lot of discounts every now and then. So it's maybe better to wait for a moment when it goes into discount. Anyway, with that being said, I want to end this video over here. Thanks a lot for watching till the end. Stay safe, stay healthy out there. If you want to support me during these tough times, because yes, a lot of jobs also got cancelled at my side, you can support me financially by pledging a bit to my Patreon campaign. And I'll make sure you get some extra content over there. Another way to support me is by watching more videos, which is, if you're in quarantine, maybe a good thing to do to keep yourself, what is it? Occupied. So I'll link one of my other videos over here. Don't forget to subscribe. Thanks a lot for watching. Keep pushing. And bye bye.